Alright guys, welcome back to another episode of Grim Dawn. So, I had a slight technical issue. As you may notice, I'm a different level than when I was last game, or last episode. I recorded an episode a couple of days ago for Grim Dawn, and it, for some reason, captured the game audio, captured me talking, but completely failed to capture any form of video. So I'm not really sure what happened there. I did a test video a few minutes ago before I started recording this episode, and for some reason it worked just fine. So I'm counting it as a glitch, and everything seems to be okay now. But I'm going to go ahead and try and get an episode knocked out real quick. You may hear thunder in the background. It's raining really, really hard right now. So I'm going to try and get this done before my power goes out. Or before lightning strikes the house and I burn out a power supply or something. Alright, so we did get a pretty good amulet last time. So that's nice. We're waiting on level 15 to be able to put that on. We did pick up a new weapon. I'll go ahead and show it to you there. It's pretty nice. I am going to use one of these components on it to give us a little bit more damage on it. Let's see, we could do fire. What else we got here? That's an armor component. That's not going to help me right now any. Frozen, that's for a ring. Armor. There's another really nice ring we have in here that we stored that we can actually wear now. So I'm actually going to go ahead and put that on. We will actually sell that. Elixir of Spirit. That's kinda... Our mana potions. We'll keep all this stuff here. I'm going to put this in here for now because we don't need it. And I've got, let's see, let's go ahead and, energy reserve, piercing damage, let's go ahead and put fire on here, let's put fire on here for now, combine, there we go, so there's our new stat trees. Pretty nice, pretty nice. Let's go ahead and get rid of those. Let's get out in the field. Let's turn on our spells real quick. Get our pet up. There we go. Alright, let's go kill some things. Also, we did get a little bit further in the map. We got a picked up a beat a boss, and we picked up this rift right out here, right outside the outskirts. So we're gonna go ahead and go back there. I do apologize for you guys not being able to see it, but it would have been a really, really boring episode because you basically would have heard me killing things and heard me talking and not really seen anything at all. So it seemed like that was kind of a waste to try and post that. Okay, so there's the cave that we came out of. We're going to go back up here. Like I said last video, the episode that has since been dubbed the missing episode. I'm probably not going to do a whole heck of a lot of the side quests just because I want you to have something to experience on your own. But I'm going to do some of them if I do run across some things while we're working through the story. So we will do that. So we'll go ahead and kill all these guys here. They are in my way. And being in my way, I mean I walked off the road and ran into their camp and started killing them. It'll teach them to be off on the side of the road. Completely not in anybody's way. Our weapon is doing significantly better than our last weapon. We've got quite a bit more damage. We're really happy about that. Because we need it. And another thing I brought up was there's a minor issue that I've noticed. Well, two minor issues. These are my main gripes for the game, and hopefully they will get fixed eventually. But one being skills sometimes don't go off when you push the button. Seems like there might be some delay, or there's you have to click the button a couple of times to get them to trigger every once in a while. It doesn't happen all the time, but I do notice it occasionally, especially with the lightning skill that we have. See, that was four clicks there to get that one to actually trigger. So that's a problem. Which, again, I hope gets fixed at some point. And I'm sure it will. Like I said, this game is fairly new out, and they haven't released a ton of patches for it just yet. So I'm sure that'll get taken care of somewhere down the road. And it's not a huge complaint. Like I said, it doesn't happen every time. But it does happen enough that it's mildly noticeable. The other thing that I've run into is... and I'm gonna make a desperate plea here to the developers, which will probably never see this video. Please, for the love of God, fix the pathing. In some places, it is damn near impossible to get up a set of stairs or across a bridge. It is incredibly annoying. And a lot of times you kind of have to fiddle with your character to get him to walk across the bridge or up a set of stairs and go a certain direction. We are dying. Oh, I did not need my map up. But yeah, so if those two things get fixed, I will be ecstatic. I'm already pretty in love with this game as it is, and definitely recommend people to check it out. It is completely worth the money. They have several different packages that offer some DLC content and things like that that you can look forward to. So I'll let you choose for that. The pack that you're seeing me play right now is the Loyalist pack, which comes with a couple of DLC items for the game and comes with the first yet, as of yet, undeveloped expansion. So I look forward to seeing that come out. Which hopefully in that expansion or in a sooner patch they will fix the pathing. Alright, anyway, I'm going to stop whining about the pathing and we're going to get on and kill some stuff. And if you're wondering, no, they didn't make me say all the nice things about the game and explain the package that I'm playing. That was just me. And I am dying again. Stop running away from me. We're picking up a lot of white junk, which we're going to have to get rid of. We don't really need to pick up that stuff anymore. It's not super necessary, so I'm not really worrying about it too much. Yes, I know I could pick it all up and run back to the vendor 100 million times to sell it all and make tons and tons of looty cash. But it's not really necessary, honestly. Alright, we're in the moldering fields, and wow, are we getting around. I mean, but. I did say but. You didn't hear that other word. Whoa! I'm very, very slow. Something has slowed me. Okay, chest. Get all this stuff in here. Definitely want the bits. The bits are your cash source, if you haven't figured that out yet. And there are a lot of them in the world. Hey, we leveled again. Fantastic. Also, in the last episode, we did manage to get a shrine opened up. So we've got another devotion point that we need to spend. So we'll do that here in a minute. Now, for the sake of my PC and my hardware and all my gear, I'm probably going to not make this episode quite as long as the last couple have been, because it is raining pretty intensely right now outside, and I do not want to have any issues. So I'm trying to get this done for you guys real quick, so you'll have an episode on the day that this comes out. But I'm, like I said, it's probably not going to be the 20 minute long that I have been doing lately. I am going to go ahead and try and mosey up towards, mosey up towards town. We'll get the rift opened up there. That'll get us further into the story, because we need to be in that town for some dastardly killing. These healer guys are really, really annoying. Really annoying. There's another one back here somewhere. I saw him. There he is. Hey, come back here. They remind me a lot of the... if you've played a lot of Diablo 2, you know the little staff guys that res the little munchkin dudes. I know that's super vague, but anybody who's spent a lot of time in Diablo 2 will know exactly what I'm talking about. They're typically red in color. They look like little shaman type dudes. And they're incredibly annoying with their resing and healing. These characters remind me a lot of them. They have a very similar kind of style to them, except they don't endlessly res their minions over and over and over. Alright, we've got quite a herd here. We can get our lightning to trigger. Kill the healer. There we go. I'm gonna go back in that house in just a second and pick up all the loot that's in there. I wanna get these guys out of the way first, because they're annoying. Alright, there's a book in here if I can figure out how to get into the house. Unfinished meal. We'll go ahead and eat that for that guy. He doesn't need it. Got our lore experience from that book that we picked up. And we'll go ahead and move on. I believe we've got to go around this way, because the road is blocked. I'll angle back towards the road here in a minute. Bugs. I really, really hate the bugs. Oh, there's a dead guy we can loot. Unlike having a bunch of dead people laying around that you can get stuff off of. That looks to be a dead end, so we're gonna go back this way. Something is shooting somewhere, and I can't see where it's at. Okay, it looks like we do actually have to go around that way. Yeah, it looks like we're going to have to cut back over here. We could have gone the other way, it looks like, too. That's alright. We'll go this way. It looks like there's somebody over here we need to talk to anyway. Go back up here to where we were. Oop, he's down here. There you are.
Well, I'll be a living person.
Alright, so we've got that guy in Devil's Crossing. We made sure to get him back to town before we start tearing up his stuff. Always the polite. Alright, now. Look like we can get through there. Can't get through there. Is there not actually a way? Okay, here we go. We can go up here. Alright, there's the road. Let's go up here and get this rift gate open, then we'll probably call the episode there. Oh, these burning guys are bad news, man. Bad, bad news. I'm gonna pick that particular white item up because I don't remember what it is at all. Can't get to you. Alright, we are now in the village. There should be a rift gate right up here. Those stairs weren't too bad. There's another city that we'll get into late in the game called Homestead, which has a significant amount of stairs in it. And sometimes it's quite a challenge. Alright, there's our rift gate, guys. Okay, looks like a wave. So let's go ahead and get the waves down. Get this gate open. We will head back to town. And typically with these, you usually get a special. Or an elite, however you want to describe them. Typically they're the ones with the giant stars over them, over their heads, that really, really hurt. That was a really loud batch of thunder there. Alright. Get these guys killed. Come here, dude. Oh, this is not funny at all. Yeah, this might be a problem. Holy cow. Yeah, that was certainly a problem. Alright. I can't say I've ever seen that many specials come out of one thing before. I'm pretty sure there are three of them. There are. And I'm going to get trapped in the middle of them if I don't get out of the way. Don't want that spell to hit me. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Wow. That is brutal, man. Alright guys, we are running long on this video though, so I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. We will go ahead and get that portal open the next time and see if we can't defeat those dudes. I appreciate you guys coming by and checking out the episode. Thanks for doing that. If you enjoyed it, please do leave a like down below. I'd appreciate it. Also, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns, leave those down below as well. One moment while I take a drink. If you would, please do flip around the channel. Check out some of the other games that I have going on right now. I'm doing a bunch. We'll take a look at that next time. Also, if you wouldn't mind, I'd really, really appreciate it if you would go ahead and swing over and click on the subscribe button. It's not hard to find. It's on a couple of different pages. I'd really appreciate it, and it's probably the best thing you can do to help me out. Hit that button. That'll get us a little bit bigger, build our community up, and help me get more games out to you guys. All right, guys, I appreciate it, and we'll see you next time.